H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
So let's get started. So let me introduce you myself. I think most of you already know about me, but just let me go through the formalities. So well, friends, my name is Shah. I've been working in IT for almost 20 years now, mainly working as a business analyst and toggling between project manager and scrum master. So that is how it goes. You know, you're a project manager sometimes, sometimes you work as a scrum master. And I have 7 years of experience teaching Agile, Scrum, and project management. Okay, so when I say project management, specifically I teach a PMP and CAPM certification. As far as my education goes, I'm an MBA graduate from San Jose State University, California. I do also hold a Scrum certification and CAPM and PMP certification also. Okay, so that's about me. And as of now, I'm based in San Diego. I work for Qualcomm as a senior most scrum master as of now. Okay, but in the meantime, so these are the different topics that will be covered in today's demo. I want you to take a look at it. So that is, you know, first we'll try to get an overview of PSM. So we'll see what this PSM is all about. Okay, and also I'll give you an idea like who can take up the certification, benefits of PSM certification, examination details. I'll throw some light on eligibility, and very importantly, we shall look into the key features of this course. Also, we'll try to get an idea about the syllabus, and very importantly, I would like to take questions from you. Okay, let's get some pointers on PSM. So first of all, this PSM, what you have, okay, it stands for Professional Scrum Master. There are different levels of PSM exams. So level one should be good enough. Nobody really writes level two. Okay. PSM one should be very good enough. Okay. Fine. Also, basically, what is the role of this PSM? Basically, PSM certification, what you have. So basically, validates individual understanding and knowledge on Scrum practices. Yes. Basically, this exam is all about testing your knowledge on Scrum practices and theory. So that's the reason this has a very good recognition in job market. Okay, it has a very good recognition in job market. Okay, also PSM makes individual industry ready to work as a Scrum Master. True, it's just not about validating your knowledge. Also, once you go through this process, you'll be industry ready. Means you're able to take up a project which is based on Scrum. So you can work as a BA on the Scrum based project, you can work as a QA on Scrum based project. Also, you can work as a Scrum Master. That's the whole idea here. Okay, perfect. Who can take up the certification? Let's say if you're an aspirant of Scrum Master, that is, if you want to, you know, enhance your career into Scrum Master positions, yes, this is exactly what you should be looking at. Okay, fine. And also, let's say you're a business analyst, or let's say you're a developer, you're a QA, or you're a project manager, and let's say if you want to be eligible for Scrum based project, okay, Scrum based project, which is the most of the cases now. Let's say if you look into the job portals, let's say dice.com, monster.com, careerbuilder.com, indeed.com, you get plenty of jobs asking, okay, we need a BA who understands Scrum. We need a developer who has expertise in working in Scrum-based projects. See, that is called Scrum-based projects. Okay, Scrum-based projects. Yes, so this makes you ready, or this makes you eligible to work for Scrum-based projects. Yes, if you see the job markets, when now these Scrum-based projects, what you have, it counts close to 80%. That's a huge number. Okay, fine. Benefits of PSM. Okay, so basically, so this is how it is trending. Okay, well, this is a very popular graph that you get to see in internet. Well, this graph, what you have, it is based on, let's say, 2017, I think. So 2017 or 16, if I have to be very precise. So basically, it says 56% of the projects are based on Scrum alone, and 8% are Scrum Ban. Next 5% is Kanban. After that, it is XP, and rest it is 30% in the sense, I mean, it can be waterfall or a RUP methodology or anything of that kind. So this Kanban or Kanban, what you have, it is a variation of Scrum. I hope you must be having an idea about it. Okay. Basically, if you see at a high level, so this is how the job market looked like in 2017 or 16. That is 70% of the jobs were based on Agile Scrum. Okay, 70% of the projects were based on Agile Scrum. Now it is more than that, of course. I know you are always in touch with the job portals. You keep watching job portals. You might have realized that almost like 80% of the jobs are based on Scrum or Agile based. Okay, so that's a very encouraging number. And definitely, even I'm a big fan of Scrum. See, and so I'm a PMP, means there are two ways to manage a project. Let me put it this way. That one is PMP way or PMI way of managing a project, or Agile or Scrum way of managing a project. Believe me, Agile Scrum way of managing a project is very, very, very efficient, if you ask me. Okay, fine. So let's say, so it's just not me who says that Scrum Master or Scrum based projects are very much in trend. You also get to hear this the same thing from Forbes. So under the article title saying Scrum Master ranked in the top 25 highest paying job, that's very encouraging. Not only, what's wrong? Okay, I think it took me to a website. Hold on a second. Okay, so not only that, even Washington Post on the title, Certified Scrum Master, one of the highest paying jobs in US. Yes, certified. Remember the word certified. That makes a huge difference. Okay, so this is the link. Of course, I'll be sharing these links with you. You can read the article. It is very interesting. Not only that, even LinkedIn says the same, most promising job. So these are the heading of the article. Okay, this is the title of the article. So you have a very interesting articles. Not only this three, I've just taken this three. Okay, there are plenty of recognized new sellers. Okay, they have rated Scrum or Scrum Master or Certified Scrum Master a very trending job. It started trending very much, you know, since 2018, believe me. Okay, it took a very great upturn. So there is no particular prerequisite for PSM certification, let's see if you ask me. But the problem is, okay, if you want to write this PSM certification or this content or the material, what this PSM organization offers, material, it assumes that you already know the basics. It kind of assumes that you have been working in Scrum-based project. Means it's not for beginner. Okay, it's not for beginner. So what I'll be doing is, first the prerequisite would be the basics. Okay, first I will be covering basics for you. Yes, first thoroughly I will be covering basics for you. After that, I'll be going through the PSM materials or PSM content or PSM syllabus, if you want to call it. Okay, so don't worry, it is taken care. Okay, next, let's understand the difference between certification and real time. Okay. What is certification? Certifications are more ideal. Okay, they're more ideal scenarios. Okay, so well, they're very straight. Okay, it is not a variation, it is not modified, it is very straight and clear. So these are called standards. Okay, it happens in every profession. It's just not about Scrum. It happens in BA, it happens in QA, or it happens in any other profession outside IT too. Okay, so this is standards. Okay, this is standards. So basically, certifications are always based on standards. Okay, always based on standards. But when this is being tested in real time projects, this gets a little bit modified. Yes, it kind of, you know, it varies to 15%, or it gets modified to 15% this side and maybe 15% to this side. So this is what called a job based scenario. Okay. So that's how, when you look into any profession in IT, always there are two types of courses. So one course is called as a certification. One is called a certification based course, and the other one is job oriented course. So for example, I know most of you are my BA students. You might have attended my BA training. So that was job oriented. So that prepared you for job. Okay. So normally there are two types of courses. One is certification based course, okay, and the other one is job oriented course. Okay, so certification is this one. Okay, this part, what I'm talking about is certification, and this part, what you have, okay, this is job oriented, which is like modified. You might have heard, right, people saying, you know, what I learned in the college and what I'm doing right now, it is a little bit different. So that is what I mean to say, the difference between books and standard and real-time situation. If you ask me, both are important. Both are definitely very important. You should know the standards. Also, you should know the possibilities of variations of it. Okay, so that's the reason what I've done is, okay, I don't want you to kind of, you know, go looking for two different courses at two different places and pay, end up paying two different fees. I don't want you to do that. So basically this course will cover both. Yes, in a planned way, but in a planned way. Okay, so it will cover both. Okay, in a planned way. I'll explain how I will be doing this. Okay, fine. So let's say this is the course what I'm talking about. Yes. First would be PSM. My main focus would be to get your examination cleared. And after that would be practical concepts. Means practical concepts means it is more of job oriented. So the plan is, first I will be preparing you PSM certification. I'll be making you eligible for PSM certification. And after that, I'll be giving you a break to appear for exam. Yes. Basically, you know, since you're spending money on exam, I want to make sure that you clear that in the first attempt. So that's the reason. First, I want to target the certification here. Okay. Once I'll give you a break. Once you finish the exam, again, you'll come back to me to learn job oriented or variations of standards. How this gets implemented in real time project, I'll be making you understand that. You see, I'm covering two course in one course. Okay. So this combination, what you have, so this makes you complete job readiness. Yes, complete means what? What do you mean by complete? Complete means you should know the standards, or you should know the standard, or you should be certified. Also, you should be prepared to handle real-time jobs. Okay, job-oriented. Okay, both. So that's the reason I'm using the word complete very carefully here. Okay. And also, it gets to resume screening. Yes. How do you think this resume screening happens? So there are different levels during your interview process. Normally, the first two levels, they take a glance of your resume, and based on that, they make a decision whether your resume should be sent to the next level or not. And glance means what? So this certification logos, especially on your resume, is something that will help you screen your resume. It's very important. Okay. Meet job requirement. Yeah, isn't it obvious? Okay, you get to see a job requirement saying we need a QA who's a Scrum certified. We need a BA who has a thorough understanding of Scrum. Okay, it says that. So that is called meeting the job requirement. Without meeting the job requirement, they don't even care to give you a call. Okay, fine. Increase interview performance, obviously. So when you go for, which is a fact that, you know, 80% of the jobs are based on Scrum. So when you go for an interview, definitely most of the questions will be based on Scrum. Yes. So since you have, since you know standards, also you know how this thing works in real time, your interview performance will be very high. Okay. Capable in managing real-time projects. Yes, managing real-time projects is no joke. Okay. You should know both. Okay. Certification standards as well as job-oriented version of it. Okay. So that's a very interesting approach of dealing with a complete package, if you ask me. And this is how your resume would look like. Okay, so that is, you have certification logo here on your resume. This makes a huge difference. See, what do you think an interview is? Maybe in an interview they spend like 10 minutes. Okay, they might ask you maybe 15 questions, isn't it? Okay, after this 15 questions, let's say you're a BA or a QA. So maybe, you know, they will ask you, let's say, 8 questions on BA, and on Scrum, okay, they might ask you the remaining 7 questions, let's say. So basically, they're just testing you on 7 questions, isn't it? If you break this down, they're testing you just on 7 questions. What about this PSM? So if you ask me, they'll test you on 80 questions. Okay, yes, this PSM exam, what you have, it is 60-minute exam, that is 1-hour exam, in which you'll be tested on 80 questions. So this is your ability. Okay, so basically, you know, the interviewer knows, okay, so I'll be spending like 5 or 6 minutes interviewing a candidate on Scrum. So instead, if anybody is certified, okay, I will just and you not interview him, okay, because you're already being tested on 80 questions. That's a huge number. Okay, so that's the reason certification plays a very important role. Okay, fine. Let's look at the key features. So it would be a live online training and the weekend classes. Okay, we have it would be Saturday. Okay, small modification here. We are made into 1.5 hour each. Okay, fine. 11 a.m. EST to 12:30 p.m. EST. 11 a.m. EST to 12:30 p.m. EST. It would be weekend classes. Okay, fine. And duration of the course is 6 weeks. Okay, somewhere between 4 to 6 weeks. Okay. And after that, once you give the exam, again, I will conduct a couple of sessions for you to make you understand the real-time version of it or job-oriented version of it. And I myself am a Scrum certified, so feel safe. Okay, real-world examples will be considered and free practice test paper will be solved in the class. So basically, I'll give you a question bank of around 200 questions. Basically, you can expect at least 70% of the questions being repeated in the exam. Also, you know, sometime, you know, registering for the exam might be a little bit complicated. So I will be helping you with the test registration also. Okay. So this is the entire thing, what I wanted to discuss with you. And if you want to register, okay, better call this number 770-777-1269. Or you can just write an email to... better write an email, training@h2kinfosys.com. Okay, training@h2kinfosys.com. Just write an email if you're interested. Okay, a training coordinator will get back to you at his earliest time.